cabinet about which there will be a press release given. But I'm here to address on one issue which pertains to our ministry, and that is, we had made an announcement earlier about home buyers, and that a lot of home buyers had approached us saying they are stuck up in a situation where they have paid up the advance and they're just not able to get their flats completed, handed over to them. A rough estimate of the study that the ministry did showed that there are over 1,600 housing projects which are stalled, and approximately 4.58 lakh housing units are stuck in it. Units. 4.58 lakh housing units, meaning you could call it as a projects are 1,600. I'm not giving you an exact number on that. Over 1,600 projects which are stalled. There are many more, but that which is stalled, we had this number. And in them, about 4.58 lakh housing units, which are stuck, 4.58 lakh housing units. That's right. We've taken a random survey, a lot of figures which came from different sources, the real estate people. We've taken inputs. Hanji. Now, we've also been meeting up with a lot of affected parties, builders themselves, other than large sections of home buyers. And you were aware that everywhere I went to meet with the tax authorities, I also post that meeting met with home buyers and many others. So the information that the ministry collected was by meeting with concerned people, affected people, and also associations which came and met us. In the last 2 months, we've held several meetings, not just with the affected parties, but also with banks, with the Reserve Bank of India. In fact, I must thank the Reserve Bank of India. Without hesitation, every time we called them, they came over for discussing this matter on the real estate and stalled projects. And one such a meeting, even the governor himself came and sat with us to discuss as to how we can have a sustainable, viable way of reaching out for the home buyers. So with all that, what we've come up now is a special window which is to be structured as an alternative investment fund, as an AIF, which will pool all these investments. Government gives 10,000 crores. We've already spoken with, say, institutions like the SBI, LIC and so on, who together will also put in money, which I think will touch 25,000 crores. SBI and LIC, we've spoken, and they others also will join in. But this will be kept open. There are a lot of sovereign funds also who have expressed interest to come into it. Gradually, we'll keep adding to the AIF corpus. Haji. Asset alternative investment fund ke nature mein chalega. Sarkar ke 10,000 crore shuruaat mein hum dal rahe hain. 10,000 crore. Aur SBI aur LIC bhi unke paise isme dalenge as an alternative fund. Uska baatcheet hum SBI aur LIC ke saath bhi kar chuke hain, RBI ke saath bhi kar chuke hain, kyunki bank isme paisa dal rahe hain. Kul milakar ke hamare shuruaat mein LIC aur SBI aur sarkar tino ko kul milakar ke 25,000 crore tak shuruaat mein hum dal rahe hain. Matlab, iska matlab ye nahi hai ki wo 25,000 crores ke saath hi hum chalenge. Isme सॉवरेन फंड्स और पेंशन फंड्स जो हमसे बात कर रहे हैं उनके पैसा भी जोड़ते जाएंगे जाते जाते के ऊपर। ये स्पेशल विंडो प्रोविजन है। इसके इसके द्वारा हम क्या करने वाले हैं, व्हाट डू वी वांट टू डू विद दिस। देश भर का मैंने एक रफ एस्टिमेट नंबर दे दिया है, 1600 स्टॉल प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं, उसमें 4.58 होम बायर्स, 58 लाख होम बायर्स हैं जिनका हाउसेस स्टक अप, 4.58 हाउसिंग यूनिट स्टक अप है, उसमें से ज्यादातर लोगों ने ऑलरेडी पे करके बैठे हैं कि उनको हाउस नहीं मिला है। 4.58 लाख हाउसिंग यूनिट्स इन ओवर 1600 स्टॉल्ड प्रोजेक्ट्स। ये फंड जो हम अभी ओपन कर रहे हैं उसके द्वारा इनकम्प्लीट प्रोजेक्ट्स जो लेस देन 2 crores का वैल्यू हर यूनिट का होगा मुंबई मेट्रोपॉलिटन रीजन में, जो 4.58 लाख हाउसिंग यूनिट्स का मैं बोल रही हूं ना, उसका वैल्यू मैं रफली बोल रही हूं, मुंबई एरिया में 2 करोड़ हो सकता है, 1.5 करोड़ हो सकता है एनसीआर में, चेन्नई में, कोलकाता में, पूना में वगैरह, हैदराबाद में, बेंगलुरु में, अहमदाबाद, अप टू दैट लेवल, एंड 1 crore इन एनी अदर पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री। फॉर दैट, फॉर दीज इनकम्प्लीट प्रोजेक्ट्स, इस फंड के द्वारा एक एस्क्रो अकाउंट में पैसा डाल करके एक प्रोफेशनल ग्रुप, शुरुआत में हम SBI कैप के द्वारा चला रहे हैं, वो ही चलाएंगे इस प्रोजेक्ट को। रेरा में रजिस्टर्ड जो भी इनकम्प्लीट प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं उनको एक प्रोफेशनल अप्रोच के तहत नेट वर्थ पॉजिटिव जिनका है, मतलब कुछ आई हैव सोल्ड सम फ्लैट्स, आई हैव मेनी मोर टू सेल, आई हैव असेट्स, ऐसे नेट वर्थ उनका असेसमेंट करने के बाद दोस प्रोजेक्ट्स विल गेट फंडेड फॉर द लास्ट फिनिशिंग स्टेज तक, 70% कंप्लीट, 30% इनकम्प्लीट। फॉर कंप्लीटिंग द 30% इनकम्प्लीट, दिस मनी विल गो टू द एस्क्रो, नॉट एट एज अ लम सम एट वन गो, वन स्टेज तक यू नीड दिस मच, यू टेक दैट मच, दैट इज कंप्लीट, यू टेक सम मोर, थर्ड स्टेज यू नीड सम मोर, यू टेक लाइक दैट, इन स्टेजेस अप टू द स्टेज दैट दे कंप्लीट वी गिव द मनी, सो दैट वंस द हैंड ओवर हैपन्स द होम बायर टेक्स इट एंड ही इज नाउ नो लॉन्गर गॉट टू वरी अबाउट हिज प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट होगा कि नहीं होगा। अगर ये NPA हो, दिस प्रोजेक्ट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन डिक्लेयर्ड एन NPA, इवन देन दे कैन बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दिस। अर्लियर आपको याद होगा we came up with 2 conditions saying those who are not NPA can benefit, and we had also said those who are non-NCLT you can benefit. Now we have withdrawn those 2 conditions. NPA भी आ सकते हैं जो NCLT में पहुंच गए मगर liquidation का announcement नहीं जो हुआ उनको इसमें शामिल कर सकते हैं। If you are not announced or if your project has not been declared as liquidation worthy, meaning if NCLT has not announced that you're going for liquidation, you are eligible to get covered under this scheme. So non-NCLT, jo condition pehle I had announced, that is not anymore applicable, NCLT bhi aayenge aur NPA bhi isme aa jayenge. That is why we had to have so many meetings with Reserve Bank and with the banks as to how they will deal with NPAs coming and benefiting from this, as to how they will benefit if NCLT, those projects which have already gone into NCLT are also brought in here. So that is why we had to spend a lot of time with the banks and with Reserve Bank also. Now we are glad to say that we have come up very clearly, keeping in mind all those projects which are largely in, I'm not excluding anything, but all those projects which are largely in affordable and middle income category, presence of large number of home buyers, those projects which have been stalled for any number of years, but whose net worth is positive will all be now finding relief. So we are not closing the chapter by saying government has given 10,000 crore, that is the end of it. We are continuously going to give money so that the AIF, the alternative investment fund that they are being started, will continuously receive money and give solution for all home buyers. I do not want to elaborate my opening statement much more. Secretary is also with me, who's put in a lot of effort to get this through. I'll open it up. We can answer all your questions. We'll also get a press release. Yeah. I will answer everybody. Aram se.
No problem. Yeah, but please, just wait.
नहीं नहीं मैं 70 का उदाहरण लिए नेट वर्थ पॉजिटिव जिनका है 50% ही कंप्लीट हुआ बाकी 50% रह गए उनको भी इसमें आने का रास्ता है 50 हो 60 हो 70 हो अल्टीमेटली नेट वर्थ पॉजिटिव इज द ओनली थिंग आई वांट
वी विल टेक ऑल द क्वेश्चंस जस्ट प्लीज वेट वन बाय वन यस सपना
सपना दास फ्रॉम सीएनबीसी ma'am, wanted to know when does the government plan to notify this scheme, number one. Number two, GUI, SBI, LIC together, 25,000 crores. What is the expectation of what will be the total size, the exposure of banks to these projects? Any number crunching on that front? And when can we expect this 10,000 crores to start from GUI?
Ask one question at a time. No? There are lots of people. I'm sure everybody will ask. Well, as I said, we opened up with this 10,000 plus LIC and SBI, putting together what I approximately expecting it to be 25,000 crores, post which I will continuously have funds, sovereign funds, which are also coming into NIIF. Also, we are talking with them. The process is already on. Some pension funds, all of them will keep adding on to it. Now, of course, the assessment, the risk assessment for the banks and everything else has been worked out with the Reserve Bank. For instance, so if a bank were to put 10% of the total money, their risk weight is going to be assessed accordingly. So all that has been worked out with the banks. And therefore, your question on, yes, we're starting with 25,000, but it will be even more.
Yes, Mr. Sinha, I think second question from this side. Yeah,
I'm telling you, cabinet is approved just now.
Ma'am, I have two small questions. One is that you said that the completion will be either 50%, 60% or 70%. What is the floor?
We are not fixing that. Oh, we are only saying net worth positive, whichever project is, irrespective of whether it's 50% complete or 60% complete, the SBA cap will appraise it and then keep releasing.
And the second part is, ma'am, you said that 1,600 projects are stuck. So any estimation about the how much money are being required to complete those projects?
Well, that will be getting into too much of a detail, which we leave the professionals to handle. But we've opened it up fairly with a relaxed approach.
Yes, yes. Jee. Please just be a gentleman. Is
there. Madam, mera sawal ye hai ki aapne bhi bataya ki jo NPA account hai aur jo 30% tak complete karne ke baad NPA ho gaye hain. क्या उनको भी इसका लाभ मिलेगा
हाँ जी एनपीए और इनकम्प्लीट दोनों का प्रोजेक्ट इनकम्प्लीट है एनपीए भी हो चुके हैं फिर भी उनको भी ये फायदा उठा सकते हैं इसका
मिस्टर लक्ष्मण राव
नेक्स्ट डू यू वांट टू एक्सपेंड ऑन इट फ्रॉम द फंड टू द प्रोजेक्ट And as FM has mentioned, it would be through an escrow account to ensure that the fund is utilized for the completion of the project. That's how the...
Please just wait for the reply.
There is a substantial inventory which is unsold, and there is also an EMI flow which starts pursuant to the project, moving up the scale of completion. Therefore, that money which comes back, the agreement itself provides that that would flow into an escrow account, that's a return escrow, on which the fund so created will have a prior right.
I think there are others also, there's not like this.
Just, madam, kya, madam, just one minute. Kya aisa sarkar ne koi survey kiya hai ki jo 1600 units all hain, jisme 485,000 units नहीं जो 1600 टोटल प्रोजेक्ट है उसमें आपके इस फंड देने के बाद कितने प्रोजेक्ट पूरे कंप्लीट हो जाएंगे क्योंकि 25,000 करोड़ देने से 1600 जो प्रोजेक्ट पेंडिंग है वो तो पूरे कंप्लीट नहीं होंगे, कुछ को 50 करोड़ का जरूरत होगा, कुछ को 200 करोड़ का जरूरत होगा। तो क्या सरकार ने कुछ ऐसा देखा है कि किसको थोड़ा सा भी अमाउंट दे दें और उसके बाद वो प्रोजेक्ट एक कंप्लीट हो जाए?
इसमें अप्रोच ये होगा कि जिसमें कम डाल करके जल्दी कर पाएंगे उसको प्रायोरिटी देंगे, मगर वो प्रायोरिटी हम सरकार से सेट नहीं कर रहे। वो एसबीआई कैप जो शुरुआत में इसको लागू करेंगे वो उनके अपने प्रायोरिटी प्रोजेक्ट का सिचुएशन देख करके, वायबिलिटी देख करके, उनके प्रोजेक्ट का नेटवर्थ देख करके वो तय करेंगे। ये प्रोफेशनली मैनेजमेंट होगा, इसीलिए जितना जल्दी हो पाएंगे उतना अच्छा है।
तो जो प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट करेंगे वो सरकारी उपक्रम होंगे जैसे?
नहीं जी, नहीं जी, जो प्रोपोट नहीं नहीं एक मिनट जी, इसमें बदलाव कुछ और नहीं कर रहे। जो प्रोमोटर है, जो बिल्डर है, जो कर नहीं पा रहे उन्हीं को ही, उन्हीं के हाथ में पैसा नहीं जाएगा, एस्क्रो में जाएगा। प्रोजेक्ट करना उनका कर्तव्य होगा, बस उतना ही है, मगर ये पैसे के ऊपर वो हाथ नहीं लगा सकते। बैंक भी उनका पुराना जो बकाया है उसके लिए ये पैसा उपयोग भी नहीं कर सकते। सीधा काम करने का ही, कंप्लीट करने का ही ये पैसा है। बैंक भी उनके बकाया इससे हटा नहीं सकते, निकाल नहीं सकते।
यस मिस्टर लक्ष्मण राव, प्लीज प्लीज, दिस इज नॉट
दूसरा यह है कि वो एनसीएलटी में भी हो या फिर एनपीए में भी हो, तो जो प्रोजेक्ट एनपीए में है, जो प्रोजेक्ट एनसीएलटी में है, उनका नेटवर्थ पॉजिटिव होने की संभावना कितनी रहती है?
देखिए आप, आई थिंक कंपनी लेवल और प्रोजेक्ट लेवल दोनों में थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन है। नेटवर्थ पॉजिटिव प्रोजेक्ट, एफएम साहब ने बात की है, उसके अंदर कोई भी प्रोजेक्ट होता है उसकी एक प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट होती है, और जो कॉस्ट टू कंप्लीशन जो एसेस की जाएगी, और उस प्रोजेक्ट से कैश फ्लो होते हैं, रिसीवेबल्स होते हैं, जो कि होम बायर से या अनसोल्ड और सोल्ड इन्वेंट्री का बकाया। तो जो वो जो टोटल कैश फ्लोज माइनस प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट, वो अगर पॉजिटिव होती है तो ही प्रोजेक्ट वायबल होगा और उसी में कोई फंडिंग करेगा। आप जिसकी बात सोच रहे हैं वो नेटवर्क जो कंपनी के लेवल पर उसकी, वो उसके कारण वो अलग है। ऐसे सारे जो प्रोजेक्ट हैं वो लार्जली वायबल प्रोजेक्ट हैं, पर उनकी प्रॉब्लम लिक्विडिटी की है, बिकॉज सिस्टम के अंदर लिक्विडिटी का फ्लो हट गया था। ये जो सरकार की जो एंट्री हुई इसके अंदर, बिकॉज सम अमाउंट ऑफ मार्केट फेलियर ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ लिक्विडिटी क्रंच हैड हैपेंड। नाउ टू मीट द लिक्विडिटी क्रंच एफएम हैज अनाउंस्ड दिस।
लक्ष्मण जी, एक और उदाहरण देती हूँ आपको। अगर मान लीजिए एक पर्टिकुलर प्रोजेक्ट है, उसमें तीन टावर्स हैं, उसमें टावर नंबर वन में 70% काम हो गया है, बाकी 30% पेंडिंग है। टावर नंबर दो में कुछ भी शुरुआत नहीं हुई। तीसरी टावर है जिसमें 50% तक हुई, बाकी 50 नहीं हुई। इसमें जो प्रोफेशनल्स के द्वारा इसका टाई अप करने के समय टावर नंबर वन को प्रायोरिटी देंगे, उसको कंप्लीट करने के लिए पैसा देंगे इन इंस्टॉलमेंट्स। As you go completing, we give you more. शायद अगर prospect है तो tower number 3 को देंगे, जहां 50% complete है, बाकी 50. Tower number 2 जिसमें शुरुआत ही नहीं हुआ, उसको नहीं देंगे पैसा। चाहे ये project का कुल मिलाकर के तीन tower का हिस्सा भी हो, फिर भी second project जहां कुछ भी शुरुआत नहीं हुई, उसको पैसा नहीं मिलेगा। जहां प्रोस्पेक्ट से जल्दी, जैसे आप पूछ रहे थे, जल्दी खत्म करके होम बायर के हाथ में सौंप सकते हैं, जिससे उनका पूरे पेमेंट भी कंप्लीट हो जाएगा, मनी फ्लो आएगा, उसी को ही प्रायोरिटी में देंगे।
जस्ट कॉर्नर राइट साइड हियर प्लीज।
मैम, जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड, इन केस ऑफ एनसीएलटी प्रोजेक्ट्स, द प्रमोटर इज आउस्टेड एंड सो देयर इज अ एंड द रेजोल्यूशन एप्लीकेंट इज नॉट फाउंड, so who's going to implement the whole scheme, number one? Number two, why have those projects which are facing liquidation been kept out? Because that is where the home buyer needs the maximum support, because there's no guarantee that the money that he's invested,
there is not a single home buyer who, if you ask me, doesn't need help. Every home buyer who's gone into a situation of having paid with the hope that they will get a house at the end of it will need help. But I have to somewhere start with working with possibilities. It's not my intention to keep anybody excluded from it. But where I have a possibility of completing quickly and giving one set of homes to those buyers who are waiting, I'll do that first. That is why I said I'm not ending the story with 10,000 plus another 15,000, 25,000 market mein jo milega. No, I'm going to keep this coming till such a time. Maximum number of troubled home buyers can be addressed. I'm keeping myself to a situation where if the declaration has happened that this is going for liquidation, there's no point in me retrieving that first. I'd rather retrieve those who are waiting to hear NCLT, give them a solution, get them out of the NCLT. So it is more aimed at get completion, get the house to the home buyers, and then deal with anybody else who may still be there asking for, you know.
Yeah, question from the left.
Yes. Ma'am, since this fund would also cater to NPA projects, will banks be given a special dispensation to classify loans given to projects that are classified as NPA? Because there's also a demand from the industry that RBI should tweak norms so that last mile funding is given to stalled projects.
Yeah, as I said, in this particular case, the negotiations that we've had with RBI, with the banks, so that we come out with some workable proposition is as regards those accounts where people are, you know, holding back the AMI because they no longer can afford to pay. And going by the prudential norms, they've already become NPAs individually. We are trying to have a dispensation through the banks so that with RBI giving a clear, sooner, I mean, now that the cabinet has given an approval, RBI also will give a clarificatory note, nothing new. Clarificatory notes so that those who are unable to till now getting hold of their flats, now if the project is coming under the scheme, they would be given that treatment of regularize their account, allow them to pay more. Once the house is given, they clear up all those pending payments and then the matter is solved as of this individual. So we are looking at dealing with individual EMI related problems where a project has got stalled. So to that extent, banks with the RBI have had discussions with us and they've all come on the same page to handle that.
Prashant, at the end here.
Ma'am, I'm Prashant, I'm ABP News. A basic question is, जो पैसा आप लोग देंगे मान लीजिए 30% कोई इनकम्प्लीट मकान है आपका कोई अनुमान है कि वो कब तक होम बायर्स को मिलने लगेगा वो मकान पूरी तरह तैयार होके कुछ ऐसा कुछ अनुमान है आपका
कि वो प्रोजेक्ट टू प्रोजेक्ट डिपेंड करता है इसलिए पहले आपको बताया गया कि वो प्रोजेक्ट जो जल्दी से कंप्लीट हो सकता हो होम बायर्स जो फंसे हुए हैं उनको ईएमआई भी देना है और रेंट भी देना है वो जल्दी से दो तरफ से ना पिस कर अपने घर में जा सके वैसे प्रोजेक्ट जो कि क्विक कंप्लीशन में संभव है वो प्रोजेक्ट टू प्रोजेक्ट उसकी असेसमेंट चलेगी इसकी एप्लीकेशन आएगी उसका प्रोजेक्ट का असेसमेंट होगा और क्विक कंप्लीशन प्रोजेक्ट्स जिसमें होम बायर को मैक्सिमम एडवांटेज है वो पहले कंप्लीट होंगे
जस्ट बट प्लीज देयर आर पीपल हु आर वेटिंग विद अस टू गिव द टाइम टू अदर्स नो समवन इज वेटिंग फॉर द क्वेश्चन
मैम यू हैड मेड दिस अनाउंसमेंट अर्लियर एंड व्हाट हैज बीन द ऑफटेक सो फार आई मीन इन टर्म्स ऑफ यू नो एसबीआई कैप्स टुडे यू हैव सेड दे विल बी द लीड प्रोफेशनल मैनेजर So what has been the kind of response so far from the industry? And more importantly, from this 10,000 crores and 25,000 crores, which SBI and thing, will there be any return from, will you get any kind of return? How much do you expect to get from this? So is it just, helping us stall projects?
Oh, no, it is not, it's not government granting something. It is an asset. In some form, right? Alternative investment fund. Obviously, the government will and the banks will retrieve their fund. It's the calculation based on which we've come through. So it is not as if the government is just throwing the money into a project. One. Second, you've also asked as to what happened. You announced earlier, most of the people who met us, home buyers or associations or builders or those associations of builders, have all said, sorry, with these two conditions, you just cannot have us come anywhere near it. It won't benefit us. And therefore, we from the government went into a deep consultation mode, brought in the RBI, brought in the banks, brought in the stakeholders, brought in the home buyers, have had several rounds of meetings. And only after that, that we've gone through this whole process of getting the RBI and the banks on board to make sure that if we remove these two conditions, and if we are therefore able to give 4.58 to start with lakh house units, which can go to the buyers, then the market itself becomes a bit more confident that they can clear the rest. That is why we've taken this approach.
Amit,
I hope to get it all back, because it's a question of people wanting to take the money. Banks are involved who funded these home buyers. Banks are involved who funded those promoters. With the government coming in with this kind of a support, we expect to clear it.
Ma'am, aapne kaha ki phase wise paisa diya jayega, builder ki zimmedari hogi, to ye paise kya builder ke paas hi jayenge?
Nahin, jo... escrow account open hoga, jisme ye professional body jo conduct kar rahi hai isko, wo monitor karke rahenge. और ये सब रेरा सर्टिफाइड, मतलब रेरा में रजिस्टर हुए प्रोजेक्ट ही है, इसीलिए वो प्रोजेक्ट में कितना कंप्लीट हर स्टेज में हो रही है इसका आंकलन करने के बाद ही पैसा उनके एस्क्रो अकाउंट में जाएगा, जो सिर्फ कंस्ट्रक्शन कंप्लीट करने के लिए ही उपयोग में आएंगे. सो आज आप मान लीजिए एक अमाउंट तक कंप्लीट किया, क्योंकि पहला हिस्सा आपको दिया गया, उसके बाद सेकेंड स्टेज के लिए जो कंप्लीशन के लिए चाहिए वो पैसा तब जाएगा वो एस्क्रो अकाउंट में. ये नहीं है कि 30% इनकम्प्लीट है, उसको पूरा 30% कंप्लीट करने के लिए मान लीजिए 400 करोड़ का आवश्यकता है, पूरे 400 वो एस्क्रो अकाउंट में गया, ऐसे नहीं है. 400 इकट्ठा पहले ही अपफ्रंट उस अकाउंट में नहीं जाएगा, स्टेजेस कंप्लीट करते करते आपको धीरे धीरे देते जाएंगे, जिससे यू आर श्योर दैट इट इज गेटिंग नियर कंप्लीशन.
Ma'am, yes, Rituparna decide.
1 minute, Rituparna. Yeah. He's been waiting for a long time.
Ma'am, just wanted to ask, would there be any change in conditions for the buyers and prices that they have negotiated while buying these properties initially?
That's not for me to comment on. I'm going in with an intention of wanting to complete. That is between the professional and the bank and the builders.
But,
and the buyers.
So, I mean, his price won't be protected in the sense that...
No, I can't get into that at all. The government's intention is to help complete the project. What happens apas mein is not for me to get into.
Ma'am, yeah. In many cases, projects have been handed over or will be handed over to, let's say, institutions like NBCC who are now were expected to complete those projects. In such cases, who then completes the project?
No, I'm not getting into those projects which have been handed over to somebody, that somebody has been assessed for what he can do, that somebody's money has already gone in as an equity. I'm not getting into those. I'm strictly talking about those projects which are still remaining unresolved, stalled. If, for instance, you are referring to a, let's say, court decided project in which NBCC has been told you are roped in, you have to complete. No, I'm not talking about that.
Yes, sir.
Madam, एक छोटा सा इनका ये जो builder project बना रहे थे, bank से loan लेकर बना रहे थे और NPA घोषित हो गए, अब जो पैसा जाएगा वो project के लिए, तो क्या time bound होगा कि आपको इस समय तक कितने
वो assessment, वो project managers जो professionals हैं, सरकारी नौकरशाही नहीं है, वो तय करेंगे कि इस project में इतने दूर तक आप इतने महीने में कर सकते हैं, अगले इतने महीने में, कुल मिलाकर के आप एक साल के अंदर कंप्लीट ही कर सकते हैं. हम भी उसी के तहत इन पार्ट्स फाइनेंस करते जाएंगे, वो आपस में वो तय करेंगे अलोंग विद द प्रोफेशनल.
यस मैडम,
सरकार उसमें भाग नहीं लेगा.
मैम, फॉर प्रोजेक्ट स्टक इन एनसीएलटी, विल आईआरपी टेक द डिसीजन और सीओसी? ऑल्सो इन द प्रेस रिलीज दे से दैट फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ फंड्स टू बी सेट अप, is there going to be one AIF or multiple funds?
This one AIF that we've created,
it is one AIF, because this is a category 2 AIF that's being proposed to set up with SBI Cap Venture as the asset management company. So what is being proposed is,
ma'am, today
last question please. Yeah.
Madam,
please wait the question on the
ma'am
right.
Today are you modifying the scheme you announced some time back, or this is a standalone fresh scheme?
Scheme was an announcement for which we had to go to the cabinet to get an approval. When I made the announcement, I made it with two conditions before going to the cabinet. Those two conditions have now been withdrawn with an elaborate preparation after consultation, giving it a structure and framework. We went to the cabinet today and the cabinet has approved the structure which we have now proposed, wherein those two conditions which I included when I announced have been now removed. That is why NPAs also can participate. That was an... No, I had just given a sketch of what I wanted to do. And even as I gave a sketch, I gave those two conditions. Now I'm giving the elaborate pictures with those two conditions removed.
Ma'am's last question from this side. Sorry.
Yeah. So there are lots of us who are stuck with incomplete projects, and these kind of home buyers do not want to spend their money because they don't know what's going to happen. Are you hopeful and confident that with this cabinet proposal, the spending will actually start increasing and that's going to help the economy?
100%, because this is after consulting so many different people who even anticipated where the hitch could occur, and having anticipated and they voiced it to us, taking that issue again to the banks, again to the RBI, we have worked to iron out the problems which may occur. So I think this is one such an example of a solution that we are coming up, where every stakeholder's concerns have been taken on board. This project has been so tailor-made that it will address suspicions which are in the minds of the people, saying, all right, you announced, but it won't work because A, because B. We've taken each one of them, both through the banks and through the Reserve Bank, and therefore we have made sure that every tweaking that is required legitimately to handle this kind of a solution has been taken. And as I said, we have not capped it at 25,000. We are going to draw in more money to come. And it is not limited to NCR and Mumbai. It is going to take every project which approaches us anywhere from anywhere in the country.
Any time frame you have thought of, ma'am?
For what?
4.58 lakh units.
Yes. What time frame? No. No, once people start coming and we are going to keep giving to them, we have left it open to that extent.
Madam, there are many cases in which the buyer has given the whole money to the builder. Now, the builder project complete for you 30 crore or whatever amount you will give, how will the builder from the government get that
money? No, that's the only thing. No, brother, that's why net worth. मैं नेट वर्थ का बात जो बोले, अगर पूरे पैसा आपने खमा दिया फिर भी आपके प्रोजेक्ट इनकम्प्लीट है और आपके प्रोजेक्ट में ऐसे एसेट्स कोई नहीं है जो ऑलरेडी हाइपोथिकेटेड नहीं हुई, फिर आप नेटवर्थ में नहीं आएंगे ना, फिर एनसीएलटी के द्वारा जाओ लिक्विडेशन प्रोसेस संभालो. नहीं आप मोस्ट नहीं, एक मिनट जी, आप मैं बहस नहीं करना चाह रही हूँ. अगर ऐसे एक्सट्रीम सिचुएशन है तो एनसीएलटी के द्वारा ही आपको सॉल्यूशन मिलेगा.
थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम. थैंक यू.